Hey, welcome back to the Mr. Excel Netcast. I'm Bill Jelen.
Basically, you start out with massive amounts of data. You say, how are we going to analyze this? Well, let's fire up a pivot table and see if we can solve this problem.
Hey, welcome back to the Mr. Excel Netcast. I'm Bill Jelen. Boy, a pivot table question today sent in by John. John has the Live Lessons DVD, and he has a strange problem. He has 10 years worth of stock data here, and he wants one chart that shows the months going across the bottom and each year as a different line. I think we can do this with a pivot table. Insert pivot table, click OK. And here's what I'm going to do. I'm going to put initially the dates going down the left-hand side. And then we'll choose something. Let's go with high as the values. Now, I'm going to change that from sum to max. That way we see the highest for each month. We're going to get the months here in a second. So I'll come here to my date field. I'm going to choose group field and say that I want to group this up to months and years. And so I'll get exactly 1 point now for each month and year. Now, what's really cool when we group a date up to two different fields is Excel makes it be two virtual fields in the pivot table field list. That allows us to take those fields and, for example, take years and move it to column labels, which gets us our years going across, our months going down. Now, let's get rid of the grand totals. So we come here and uncheck both grand totals for rows, grand totals for columns. Click OK. And then finally, we're going to create a chart from this. I'm going to go back to Insert Chart, choose a line chart like that. And there we have it. So we have the various years from 1999 to 2008 as separate lines, and then the various months. So it started back here in 1999, went up, and then in 2000, big crash, and has just been kind of cruising along here the whole time. So there's one way to take that data at a daily level or a weekly level, roll it up to months and then years, and then create a chart from that. I want to thank John for sending that question in. I want to thank you for stopping by. See you next time for another Netcast from Mr. Excel.
Thanks for stopping by. We'll see you next time for another Netcast from Mr. Excel.